What's going on, everybody? My name is Michael, your RV guy here at the Great Outdoors RV in Greeley, Colorado. Today we got an important video for you. We're gonna go over how to level and stabilize your camper, why it's important, and how to do the job right. Now the first thing I'm gonna go over is why. Why is it so important to level and stabilize your RV? It takes a lot of time, it's a lot of work, it's not very fun. Well, I'll tell you what. These things, yes, in essence, are homes on wheels, but they're built a little bit different. They're designed to be flexible. They're designed to move for you so that way you can get into different places. The problem with that is if you park this RV and just hope that it's sitting at the right angle, you may end up damaging a ton of stuff in that camper. As you come up on the side of this one, for instance, you got two different kinds of slides there. Now, if that camper is not level and it's leaning just the right way, you might have one motor working harder than the other. And if you do that, you may end up wearing that motor out just a little sooner than you thought. And those are not fun to replace. Another one is your doors. So if that camper's not level, doors may pop open. You may not be able to close doors right. The glides on your drawers and stuff, they may not feel right. It's important to make sure that that's level so that those doors all close them. Your fridges, if you have a gas electric fridge, the flow of the gas lines will not work properly. You may end up damaging that fridge, and those are definitely not cheap to replace. If you don't level this properly and use the product the way it was intended, you may end up damaging a ton of stuff and causing yourself a whole lot of headache. Now, depending on the type of RV you have, there's gonna be a different way to level or stabilize your camper. It's also important to know that leveling and stabilizing are two different things. Stabilizing is what you do after the camper is already level. Leveling is what you do so that way your bacon doesn't fall off the table. Now, when you're looking at different RVs, some fifth wheel, some of that fancy stuff will have what's called auto level, and you just push a button and crack a beer. But most campers on the market are gonna have some kind of manual setting or some kind of electric option. Now, with the manual, this is called a scissor jack. You're gonna see all different kinds of configurations, especially as time goes on. A lot of these manufacturers are putting on different kind of manual jacks. This one right here is what you have been seeing for years. It's called a scissor jack. It's very affordable. They're very, you know, easy to put on, easy to take off, and easy to put down and up. Now, every camper that you get is gonna come with something like this. This is how you actually put the scissor jack down. You also can use an impact drill, but the reality is that may void your warranty. Yes, it is a lot easier to put it up and down and, you know, get right to partying and everything, but if it voids your warranty and that's something you're worried about, maybe just use this. But it's as easy as this. You just put the end in right here and you just crank it down. So once the camper is already level and you need to stabilize the camper so that way it stays level, you just put these down. And that way that's actually sitting on something that's gonna be solid. It's also important to know on these scissor jacks, you don't wanna extend them 100%. If you do that, it's gonna reduce a lot of that structural integrity. If you do it at about where it's at right now, so about 70% or so when it is extended all the way to the point where it is stable, that's probably perfect. Now on an electric one, these are a lot easier. You pay a little bit more money for something like this, but they are a lot easier to do. All you're gonna have to do is once the camper is level, I gotta keep mentioning that, all you're gonna do is push a button and it's gonna go down, or you're putting it up and it's gonna go up. But it's very easy to do. It's all one button for, you know, each electric stabilizer. So you got one up here in the front, one back there in the back. Now, for those of you that took out a second mortgage on your camper and got a fancy feature like auto level, all you gotta do is find where the auto level button is and just hit the button, crack a beer, call it a day. But if you didn't end up spending that extra money and you have a manual stabilizer or an electric stabilizer, there's a couple tools you're gonna need to actually level that. You need some kind of carpenter's level or a bubble level, so that way you can tell where your camper is at. You're gonna need some kind of wheel chock, and you're gonna need some kind of leveling block. These are used for all different things. You're gonna need the wheel chock so that your camper doesn't move after you have it level. You're gonna need these leveling blocks so that way you can get the camper level. And you're gonna need this so that way you know when it is level. Now let's go actually show you how to do it. So So we're up here on our upper lot now. Today, we're gonna pretend this is your campsite. So when I was backing this in, I was kind of thinking, where's my power station? Where are my sewer hookups? Today, we're gonna pretend that this right here is your power station. So on this camper, we have our power hookups back here and we have our sewer hookups right there. So I think this is gonna be a pretty decent spot to make it a little easier to set up everything. Now, when you're leveling your camper, there's two things you have to do. You have to level it side to side and you have to level it front to back. So we're gonna start with the side to side because that'll be a heck of a lot easier to level the front to back once the side to side is done. So looking at the camper right now, looking at it, you'd think it's probably level, but in reality, it's not even close. So on this camper right here, we don't have a bumper, we don't have a middle storage compartment, and this ladder is off to the side. So if I use this ladder, I would get an inaccurate reading. But the whole idea is I need to figure out where I'm at. So to do that on this camper, I'm actually gonna go inside. You could do that in every camper. I think it's a much more accurate way of reading everything. So I'm gonna go inside here. I'm gonna put the level right in the middle of the camper and try to figure out where I'm at. What it's telling me right now is we're a little bit too high on that side. So what I'm gonna need to do, I'm sorry, a little too low on that side. We need to go up a little bit. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put some Lynx levelers underneath the tires to get that side up a little bit. So we actually kind of predicted we're probably gonna need about one layer of Lynx levelers, and I think that's gonna be completely fine. You can use wood for this. There's all sorts of things you can use, but just make sure you're using a 2x8 so that way it'll actually fit the tire. So now what I gotta do is I gotta get it up on this side a little bit. So I put the layer of Lynx levelers there. I'm gonna put my stairs away and we're gonna shut the camper up. Now the whole idea here is I need to make sure I can do this by myself. I don't wanna have to rely on other people to do it. So I'm gonna teach you a method that way you can do it when you're just by yourself. You don't have to think about this too much. So first thing I'm gonna do is set those Lynx levelers right up to the tire. That way I know where I'm gonna have to back it up to. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go on the other side of the camper here and we're gonna go over to the driver's side of the vehicle. The way I do this is I make it so that way I can do this by myself, that you don't wanna have to rely on other folks if you're just by yourself here. So what I'm gonna do is make a line right at the back of my tire here, right in the middle. Now I know how far I gotta back up once I get those Lynx levelers set up. I'm also gonna make a line right on the front. So that way when I get out of my truck, I know I'm exactly where I wanna be. I know the camper is where I want it right now. So what we're gonna have to do now is pull the truck forward a little bit, slide those Lynx levelers under where the tires are gonna be, and then when I back up, I'm only backing up to those lines. So as you can see, you don't gotta move the truck up very much. You just have to get it out of the way of the levelers so that way I can back the truck back over them. So now what we're gonna do is go on the other side of the camper and we're gonna set our levelers in the spot that they need to be. All I should have to do here, you know, as long as everything worked right, is I just gotta grab these and put them in line with the tires. And now when I back up the truck, if I back up my truck to the two lines that I set on the tires, that should be right in the middle and we should be good to go. So let's see how we do. So now that we got the camper backed up onto the perfect spot, let's try to figure out how we did. So we're gonna open up the door here, and just like at the beginning of the video, I'm gonna take my bubble level right in the middle of the floor and try to figure out how we did. So we're gonna come in here, I'm gonna put this down in the middle again, and that is dang near perfect. All right, that works for me. So now that we're level side to side, and before I take this camper off of the ball, I'm gonna make sure that we put some wheel chocks under those wheels so that way this camper doesn't roll on. So we're gonna go over to the other side and we have some Lynx level wheel chocks here. We're gonna put them on either side of the wheel. So now we should be good. So now we're gonna level the camper front to back. And to do that, we're gonna go use the tongue jack. So let's go over that way. Now, remember in the beginning of the video where I talked about leveling and stabilizing two different things? We haven't even touched our stabilizers yet. Just keep that in mind as I'm doing this stuff. So we're leveling this camper. So we're now gonna go down on the hitch here. So that way it lifts off the ball and we can start to get a change in direction. Okay, so now that the camper's off the hitch, let's see where we're at. So what I'm gonna do is take my bubble level, and I'm actually gonna go right to the inside of this camper right here. Now you can use storage compartments for this. If you have a middle storage compartment somewhere, it doesn't really matter on the side of the camper. You just need to figure out what kind of pitch you're at. So right now it's telling me that I'm a little bit too high on my tongue. So what I'm gonna need to do in this situation is move my truck forward a little bit so that way I can bring the tongue jack down a tiny bit. So let's do that now. So now that the camper is off the truck, out of the way, I can bring this tongue jack down just a tiny bit more and we should be good to go. All right, let's see where we're at. I'd say a tiny bit more and that is perfectly level. So now, once the camper is level, what we're gonna need to do is stabilize the camper. So we're gonna be using these. Today in this video, I'm not gonna be using an impact drill. Like I told you before, that might void the warranty, and this is a brand new unit, so we wanna take care of it. So in every camper, you're gonna get something like this. This is what you're gonna use to actually bring your manual stabilizers down. So now I'm gonna do that, and there's four contact points on this camper. Now that we're level, it's time to make sure that this camper's stable. So that way when you're walking around the camper, you're not rocking everything around. So we're gonna do that now. We're gonna do it one at a time. So these are the new manual stabilizers that came into the industry. A lot of Forest River products are coming with them. I really like them. They seem to work really well. They go down a lot faster. Even using the hand crank here, this is a breeze. So now, it's very important to note, there's a lot of videos on the internet about these things. These are not meant to lift up anything. It's not meant to lift up any weight off the suspension. They're not weight bearing. So the whole idea is just to make contact with the ground, so that way if the camper you start walking on one side, it's not gonna move at all. You want it to just be exactly flat. So right now it's just about there. I'm gonna go a tiny bit more and this side should be completely perfect. There, that should be completely fine. So now we're gonna do all the four corners. All right, one more and we're done. Now the last thing to do once you get this camper stabilized is you're gonna stabilize your steps. You don't wanna walk in and all of a sudden trip up the stairs the first thing you do. So we're gonna get this one down, we're gonna adjust our steps, and then this camper is ready to have slides opened up if it had them, to be hooked up to sewer, to be used at its full capacity. So let's go over to the other side here, let's set up our steps and we're gonna call it a day. So first I'm gonna put this away so that way we don't lose it. So on all these steps, you're gonna have some kind of adjustment down at the bottom here. On this particular one, we got a little button right here. I'm gonna bring out the leg just a little bit more. We'll see how that looks. Perfect. So now you can see on the bubble, we are perfectly level front to back. We are perfectly level side to side. And in essence, folks, that is how you level and stabilize your camper. My name is Michael here at the Great Outdoors RV in Greeley, Colorado. Give us a call at any time. We'd be happy to help in any way we can at 970-313-4337.